What's up, guys? Welcome back to A Last Human's Garage Home Life. It's been quite a while since we had a home life, hasn't it? What we're doing today is a couple bathtub fixes, all right? So I'm going to show you the two issues first. First off, the shower plug does not work well. Second off, the drain does not work. And down is release. And you have to hold it the whole time, okay? Let's check this out real quick. I'll just show you the shower diverter not working well. Ready? So that's the first thing we're gonna address. And as we said, the second thing, it does not drain itself. You have to hold it down. So I have reviewed the architecture between these two parts. Yes, architecture, it's complicated stuff. I've never done it. So what you have your drain, which is just a 6-inch pipe over to one pipe that's going all the way up and down. And we'll see when we take this out. All this is holding a little bucket, a little bell on a rope, which sinks into a pipe and stops the drain. And that's all that is. And this is self-contained on a pipe, which is right out of the wall. I'm gonna take my chance. So you can either, there's a couple types of your faucets here. You might have a set screw in the bottom, which is pretty rare, or else you have a basic twist off where it unscrews. That's probably what I have. Let me take a look under here a little bit. Yeah, I do not have any set screws under here. So, but what I do want to do is razor blade this little silicone, just to make sure, you know, make it easier to unscrew. And we'll go ahead and look at this and pull out the parts. Then I'll be going to Depot, buying a couple new parts, just trying to fix this. This is our worst bathroom that we haven't done anything with. It's the wallpaper from the 70s. This is the one that needs the remodel the most. The kids' bathroom, as you can tell. So, yeah, I just want a couple little tweaks for now. This isn't the time to be remodeling a bathroom. So I'll be back in a bit. So yeah, quick tip on this, the channel locks will help. This was rather tight. I did slice the little silicone, but it didn't make any difference. It was really tight. So it took a lot of effort, even with a channel lock. So normally you're not going to be able to just take this right off with your hand. But now I think I can probably now do it with my hand. I'm not sure. Let's see here. There we go. Hopefully you can still see with the crotch cam. And you'll see what's in there. And of course, I'll clean up the silicone later. Yep, that's all it is. A yucky. Man, does that thing even move? That thing's all bunged up in there. All kinds of stuff. Pull that out. And y'all clean it. But this basically, if you can kind of see in there, it's like a shut off. And it just loses its whole seal. See how loose it is? And the water just can't be sealed up tight. This one's pretty junky. So that's the first thing I'm gonna go look for at Home Depot, is a new one of these. Pop it right in there. Get off some of this stuff. And you actually don't really need the silicone around this edge, is just for prettiness, really. The threads are what do it, and I will clean off the threads a bit and probably use some, maybe a little tape. If I'll see how clean I can get it, but that's it for the spout. That's where we're at. And as you go a little deeper, you then see some of the, probably the old tape, which was even the job before the one that was on there, where they made a bunch of gunk on it, which you don't need. So I'll also take off all this tape. All right, now we're taking off the switch or latch. There's a lot of different names for it. Lever, you can find it with the search word lever sometimes. And I'll show you the big bucket on a string, which is the weirdest thing. It's amazing how it can work, but I guess it does. And this house is old. I doubt that I have my back plate bolted properly in the back. So if you were to snake this thing, you gotta be extra careful as you're wiggling that pipe, because you don't want it to come out of the T down at the bottom where the drain connects into it. This vertical pipe, you don't want it to come out of the T, or it could be very difficult to get back in. As I'm talking, the tub would have to come out. So, but that's only if you're gonna, you're gonna snake it, really rattle it around and give it a big jostle, the colossal jostle, you know. King Kong Bundy versus Andre the Giant. And we'll take out the magical bucket. Whoa. Check that out, guys. Up and out. Woo. Beautiful. I know that I personally had never seen what this was until I started researching it. Have you ever seen this? You can see a little corrosion in the bottom. One important thing is that you want this open side always at the bottom, as that's a pipe, and it will, if it overflows, it'll drain here. If you have it up, you know, it'll get super full and spill. You want your closed section here, which is all corroded now, as you can see, facing down. And as we said, this piece just lowers into a pipe down here, and that's literally how it blocks the drain from coming through, from draining out. It blocks the water from going down this drain into the main pipe because it plugs that side cross right there with this little bucket. So I will be cleaning all this. Let's take a look here, and you can see here that I will be getting a new one of these because it is very, hence the, this will come off with a cotter pin, you can see. Easy stuff here. I don't want to just bust it and break everything. I'll take my time. But you see this is spring activated, and it should normally pop real nice into on and off. But because this whole spring mechanism is worn out, that is exactly why this piece doesn't stay properly. So I'm also going to look for not any of this. This is fine. A switch. I'm gonna look for this switch right here. That's all I'm gonna look for at the depot. All right, guys, we took out our little cotter pin, and you know, I probably have one in my toolbox if I need a better one, but this is it right here. This piece should come all as one, including that hole in it there. And right here, check that out. It's really, really rough. Scraping, it barely stays, it's just all corroded up, probably years and years old. And the spring isn't doing much work anymore. The spring is what helps you snap it into place. So I'm gonna go out, buy two pieces here, and come back and install them. And then we've done our quick bathroom bathtub retrofit. Before we head out, just wanted to mention that you do have an adjustment here. However, you really do not want to adjust it unless you have some very weird issues, as it can be very hard to adjust just right. This has to sit right in the right spot, not too high, not too low. But you do have the adjustment here. If yours isn't quite sealing right and you really want to mess with it, you just loosen your lock nut and you can adjust the length of the rod and how far it goes up and down. All right, guys, we are back. So aside from a storage bin I bought, let's see how much these pieces were. The latch was $11 and the spout was $12. And we're hoping they're the right ones. So there's our latch and our spout. Make sure everything lines up just nice. So let's see, I'll start with the spout. I'm gonna double Teflon both layers of the insert here. So let's do a little Teflon tape to start with. I'll be right back. So the direction you put Teflon tape is very important. I don't want to interfere with the threads and block it either. What you want to do, this is backwards. You want to do the Teflon tape so it tightens as you screw something on, okay? So let me get this out of here. So since I'm going to be screwing something clockwise, this will also go clockwise. Notice how I am trying to avoid the very tip a little bit to make sure it does not, it's wet. It would still be all right, but I think I'm gonna dry it a little bit first. But you're gonna go clockwise. So when you turn it, it's tightening it. You put it backwards and you turn it, it's gonna just pull all the tape off as you tighten it, okay? All right, so for this particular one, first I'm putting on the adapter, which it's sealed on this end, so you have to put it on this end with the tape in the correct way. Finger tight is really all you're gonna need, especially when you tighten that outer piece on, it's gonna finish tightening that. So that's what we got there. Now I'm gonna put Teflon on this piece also. Just, you know, why not? Make it perfect. All right. Let me get over here a little bit. Try and get this started. There we go. And turn it until it hopefully bottoms out. We'll see how close it gets. Let me use my strong hand now. Probably it. I don't really want to go around again. It'll get a little bit too tight. So we'll test that. I think I'd probably like to do the other piece first before I test everything and just see how it goes. Man, look, I guess I can clean a brand new freaking part and it has a stain on it. All right, looks good though. Looks good. So we'll take out the next piece here. It actually comes with new screws, which is nice. I was just worried that it might be a little bit smaller, but I think it's actually just right. I think it's just right. Let me find my old piece here. Open this up. They call it mellow yellow. Yeah, the holes are the same. All right, now remember that disgusting thing over there. Look at that. Remember, your bottom is going to point downward. So you can see here, it came with the proper connector right there for your cotter pin. Let me get my screen back. Just like that. Put the cotter pin through, you're good to go. This is probably good. Let me set it up real quick. All right. Cotter pin is through. Bent pretty nice. Looks fine. And we have our final piece here. So, oh, it always makes so much noise. So let's get in here. Get the camera, get the crotch cam, crotch view set up. And lay this beautiful bad boy in there. See, this is a pipe in here. It's a pipe. So you could also pour CLR in there if you got a bunch of buildup. Let's see here. It's a little bit crooked. Okay. I actually had it twisted, so I gotta turn it around. Make sure all my hooks are nice and loose. That's it. See here. I think that'll be it. I don't know. It's just not quite as... Oh yeah, that is correct. It'll lock in the top. See, I was seeing that the bottom was wobbly. I forgot. The bottom is indented, so it's not going to go the same. To be safe, or to be... Shoot. Oh, to be smart, I'm just going to use the new screws. Looks like they are the same, so let me get those open. All right, the new screws came with the new cotter pin, so I'm going to replace the cotter pin. The last thing you need is having it break in there and you can't get your thing out. So what the hell? I'll take the extra time. Let me go do the cotter pin and I'll be right back. All right, guys, the final testing. Please just let this work. It'd be cool if it works. It may not be. Oh, an important thing with this thing. It even says on the directions, which I didn't show you, there's supposed to be a tiny dribble. It's like a pressure release thing. A drop, a little slow drop, whatever. It's not 100% airtight. So just if you see that, it doesn't mean it's not working, okay? What am I doing? Oh, yeah. Going this, pulling it up, getting our shower going. Yes. Woo. That's about normal, and it could even get less, but that is normal, and it's a lot better than it was before. So let me let this fill up for a minute. If you notice, the switch is in the up, meaning it pushed the bell down, meaning it clogs the drain, okay? Let's turn this off. Not draining, see? Now let's see if this thing will stay in its freaking spot. Hell yeah, good funnel in there, good tornado. That's it. The part feels a little flimsy, but I mean, that's all it does. I mean, what else are you gonna need, you know? Up or down? Oh man, it used to take, didn't turn that off all the way. Oh, I didn't release it. It didn't release by itself. It used to take a half hour to drain a tub. Now it'll drain super quick. That's the last of it. What are you doing?
I'm watching you fix my shower.
Well, yeah, it's fixed.
Yes.
It doesn't leak out the middle anymore, and the drain is all fixed, so it won't fill up with water when you're having a shower.
Oh, good.
All right. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching Last Humans Home Life.